2014 marks the 50th anniversary of the first Surgeon General's report on smoking and health. This series of videos celebrates the progress made and the work still to be done to end tobacco-related disease and death, and to make the next generation tobacco-free.
The strongest relationship between cigarette smoking and health is in the field of lung cancer.
50 years ago, Dr. Luther Terry shocked the nation when he announced in the first Surgeon General's report that smoking caused lung cancer and was linked to heart disease. Dr. Boris Lushniak, the nation's acting Surgeon General, released the 32nd Surgeon General's report on smoking and health in January 2014.
The report comes out with brand new information, an association with brand new diseases that we've not seen before that have been associated with tobacco use.
Though all the previous 31 Surgeon General's reports on tobacco have covered important issues, certain reports were especially powerful. The 1998 report detailed the negative effects of smoking on racial and ethnic minorities and looked at aggressive tobacco marketing aimed at these groups. The 1986 and 2006 Surgeon General's reports changed how the public viewed exposure to secondhand smoke.
We now have smoke-free workplaces. We can no longer smoke in restaurants and lounges and bars.
Since the 2006 report, more than half the states have enacted smoke-free laws.
We know what works. What works includes things such as increasing the price of tobacco products, includes an emphasis on cessation programs so we help individuals who are addicted to nicotine and nicotine products. The goal is very apparent. We have to be out there to help individuals.